Hi, I'm Rick with TGW.com. I'm holding the new Ping G430 Max driver. It's my intent to tell you who's going to want to try this driver, how it's going to help that type of player shoot lower scores. I got to hit this club for the first time. I'll go over my experiences and then I'll touch on some of the key features and technology that goes into this great new driver from Ping. Listed are the standard specifications. You can see that there are three different loft models available. But remember, with the new Ping G430s, you can definitely tune your trajectory by adjusting the hosel setting. Each of the drivers and each of the lofts can be adjusted plus a degree and a half of loft, minus a degree, and minus a degree and a half. These drivers can also be put into a flatter setting than standard, which is going to especially help people who tend to miss left. Ping is offering many different no upcharge shaft and grip options. I got to hit this driver with the Ping Tour 2.0 graphite shaft and the Golf Pride Tour Velvet 360 grip. But remember, TGW.com will accommodate any of your custom requests. Ping is offering three different drivers in the G430 line. They're offering an LST version, which stands for low spin technology. It's going to be for a player typically with a little bit higher club head speed who's looking to reduce backspin on their shots to maximize their distance. They're offering an SFT version, which stands for straight flight technology. That club is designed especially to help players reduce the big miss to the right. And this one, the G430 Max, is going to be kind of their workhorse of the driver category. It's going to fit the broadest range of players. It's designed mainly for players who don't have a consistent miss on the heel or toe, but are looking for maximum forgiveness across the face. And with its deep centered center of gravity, is going to help players get the most out of their drives, providing a high launch with mid to low spin. When getting to hit the new G430 drivers for the first time, I'm pleased that they have the appearance of previous models. It looks very forgiving, looks very easy to hit at address. You still keep the turbulators on top of the club for aerodynamics. You can see a new addition to the crown of the club. Ping is using carbon fiber in the crown, and that is visible over previous models. And the aesthetics, Ping has just brightened up the aesthetics to give the G430s a fresher look. One thing that I felt was very pleasing at impact was the sound. Ping engineers have worked on fine-tuning the sound. The G430 gives a more desirable, more pleasing experience at impact over previous models. So I think they've done a great job there. When getting to hit these new drivers for the first time, I was swinging the 9-degree G430 Max driver. I was swinging at an average of 101 miles an hour club head speed. I was generating average ball speeds of 146, so very efficient there. My launch angle was nice and high at 14 degrees, hitting just a few degrees up on the golf ball with an ascending blow. Spin rates were at 2,300 RPMs average. That gave me a max height of 95 feet, right at the top of the trajectory window, a descent angle of 37 degrees, and an average carry distance of 253 yards. My shot pattern as a whole was only 1 yard left of center, so I felt like this club is very straight, not a lot of left or right bias. To talk about technology, I'd start with the new optimized T9S Plus face. It is a shallower, much thinner variable face. It allows the face to flex across the face. It's going to provide higher ball speeds on shots that are not even hit in the center of the club. And something new that Ping is using on their driver line for the first time is the term they tout as spinsistency. And that is simply they are changing the vertical roll radius of the face to provide higher ball speeds and less spin on shots hit low on the face. Shots hit low tend to have more backspin, so they are actually kind of de-lofting the bottom of the club. Spin is the opposite of compression, so by reducing the spin, they're going to give you longer drives on the shots hit low. And another great feature about the G430 Max is the CG shifter that's in the back. This is a 25 gram high density weight. It can be shifted into the drop position by placing it into the heel port or into the fade by positioning it into the toe. And it's going to influence ball flight of up to 8 yards one way or the other. And another option that's available in the G430 Max driver line is a high launch build. Ping will use a lighter weight Alta Quick shaft, a lighter weight Lampkin grip, and reconfigure the tungsten sole weight of the club to lighten the overall weight of the club, allowing players with slower club head speeds the ability to swing faster and pick up to 9 yards of distance. So if the new Ping G430 Max driver sounds like it might be a good fit for your game and you want to give it a try, go ahead. TGW.com offers a 30-day mulligan buyback on any standard stock order and up to 90 days should you configure a custom Max order. Ping's most forgiving G430 Max driver with the longest distance gains to date. You can check this out. Check out our other product review videos all at TGW.com.